Hi everyone, my name is Shivaji Shah. Welcome to our YouTube channel. Today I will discuss a very important and very scoring topic of ICSE Plus 10 and any boards exam, the ratio and proportion. This is a very important and scoring topic. So first, before I how to approach the problem of ratio and proportion, I will show you what is a what do you mean by ratio. Suppose consider A and B some non-zero quantity. They are non-zero quantity. That means A and B can be anything, but it cannot be zero. And A and B be the same unit, then the fraction of A by B, the fraction A by B is called the ratio between A and B. The fraction, again repeat, the fraction of A by B is called ratio of A and B, and it can be written as A is to B. I will repeat again. Suppose A and B some two non-zero quantity, and A, B are same kind and same units. Then A by B, the fraction, is called the ratio between A and B, and A then is represented as A is to B. Okay. So there is some confusion about the two terms here, is same kind and same unit. So what does it mean, same kind and same unit? I will give you some 2-3 examples to understand the, what is the meaning of same kind and same unit. Case one. Suppose A or Ram is 16 years old and Rahim is 23 years old. What did I write? Ram is 16 years old, Rahim is 23 years old. Then what happened? What is the ratio of the ages of Ram and Rahim? The ratio of ages between them equal to 16/23, and it also written as 16:23. So in this case, the ages are two same things. Here also 16. Here is first case for Ram, it is also an age quantity, and case of Rahim, it is also age quantity. And the unit, 16 years old and the 23 year old. The unit and the things are both the same. That is why I can apply the proportionate, the ratio of I can apply the ratio or fraction. Then I can say that because of the same kind of same unit, we can ratio or we can write it like that. Now next, case 2. In this case, suppose a pen is rupees 1 and a pencil is 75 paisa. Okay, now in this case, for the both are monetary thing. The both have a costing, some cost. The both is related to money. So that is in both cases they are same kind. What is the same kind? They are both related to monetary. But in case of pen, it is written as rupees, and in case of pencil, it is rupees as paisa. In this case, so they are same kind, but they are not same unit. So what we have to do now? We have to convert either rupees to paisa, or we have to convert paisa to rupees. Now I convert 1 rupees to paisa. So we all know 1 rupee equal to 100 paisa. Okay. Now then, now they both are same kind and also they have same unit. That is why I can written as its ratio, like 100 by 755, that is 100:75. So I am repeating again, here they are both a monetary case, they are both a some costing, but their unit are different. That is why I have to change the unit of rupees to paisa, then I will go for the ratio. Now write it down and I will go to the next case. Now suppose Ram travels 8 km and his age is 12 kg. What did I say? I said Ram travels 8 km and his age is 12 kg. Now see very carefully. This is a distance phenomena and this is a age phenomena. Okay, they are not same kind. Then if they are not same kind, we don't need to change their, and we cannot change their unit also. So if the kind or the species, type of species become changing, we cannot apply the ratio formula. Okay, so in case one, I said about two ratio of two ages, then I told about paisa and rupees ratio, and next last in example I show you that the two different things cannot be considered ratio. This is the fundamentals of ratio and proportion. This main important property of ratio, if A is to B, can be written as A by B. If we multiply both A and B by some non-zero quantity, suppose M is non-zero quantity, then I can write that MA by MB. It does mean that if I multiply some integer with both numerator and denominator, the ratio cannot be changed, the ratio will remain same. So I will give an example. Suppose instead of A by B, I write 2 by 3. Now if I multiply both numerator and denominator by 4, what is become 4 into 2 and 4 into 3. Okay, now it become 8 by 12. And if you cut both these, we will get 2 by 3 again. So if you multiply some integer with in this fraction, we get the same ratio. The ratio remain unchanged. And also, if we divide it by some integer, suppose A by B is divided by A by M and B by M, the ratio remain also same. Just like that, if I ratio is 2 and ratio is 3, if I divide it both by 1, then it remains same. So I can conclude that if an integer is multiplied and divided by both, if some integer and non-zero integer is divided and multiplied by the fraction, the ratio remain unchanged. This phenomena will help us to solve the problem. So I will show you so this is a problem of year 2002, and I will show you how to approach these types of problem. This is a type 1 problem of ratio. Here given A is to B equal to 5:3, and find 5A plus 8B is to 6A minus 7B. For solving this type of problem, we have to take A by B equal to 5 by 3. Okay, then listen and see very carefully. I will take A equal to 5K and B equal to 3K, where K is an integer and K not equal to 0. Fine. Let's take A equal to 5K and B equal to 3K. Now this ratio can be written as 5A plus 8B by 6A minus 7B. Now I put this value of A and B in this fraction. So what is the value of A? Is 5K. So I can write here 5 into K, and here the value of B is 3K. अगेन 6 इंटू 5 के माइनस 7 इंटू 3 के 5 इट इज आई पुट हियर आई पुट ऑनली पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए एंड बी कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस सो 5 इंटू 5 25 के प्लस 24 के 6 इंटू 5 30 के नेक्स्ट माइनस 7 इंटू 3 इज 20 के एवन आई एम चेकिंग दिस वन अगेन 5 ए मीन्स 5 इंटू 5 के ए प्लस 8 बी इंटू 8 इंटू 3 के या 6 ए मीन्स 6 इंटू 5 के एंड माइनस 7 इंटू 3 के इट बिकम 25 के प्लस 24 के बाय 30 के माइनस 21 के एंड इट बिकम 24 प्लस 20 25 प्लस 20 49 के बाय 9 के कट इट बिकम 49:9 सो दिस इज आवर आंसर आई रिपीटिंग अगेन हियर आई टेक द फैक्ट गिवन फ्रैक्शन ए बाय बी इक्वल टू 5/3 देन आई टेकिंग बोथ साइड्स के ए इक्वल टू 5 के एंड बी इक्वल टू 3 के देन आई पुट द वैल्यू इन दिस फ्रैक्शन एंड आई गेट 49:9 ओके दिस इज आंसर वन एंड दिस इज अ टाइप वन प्रॉब्लम ऑफ रेशियो Now, this is a type 2 problem. This problem is actually a reverse problem of previous one. So, how do you approach this one? Here, the fraction is 3a by 2b by 5a into 3b. Okay. And the fraction is given as 18:29. So, I have to apply a cross multiplication rule. What happened? 29, I cross multiply each other. 29 into 3a plus 2b equal to 18 into 5a plus 3b. Done. Now 29 into 3 equal to 87a and 29 into 2 equal to 558b. Now if I multiply 18 into 5a, it become 90a and if I multiply 18 into 3b, it become 54b. Now I collect the a term in one side and b term in other side. So if I collect it, 87a, now 90a minus 87a equal to 58b minus 54b, this becomes 3a and this becomes 4b. So a by b equal to a by b equal to 4/3. A by b equal to 4/3. So ratio of a is to b equal to 4:3. So what did I do here? Here just this is a reverse one. It is came 2016 and I say 3. At first I applied the cross multiplication rule. Then I collected b, taken a one side and b other side. Then I will divide a by b and I get the ratio a to b. This is the second type problem. Now I will show the third one. Now this is a type 4 problem. Here what it said, the two numbers are in ratio 3:5. If 8 is added to each number, then the ratio becomes 2:3. Find the number. Here the fraction is 3/5. Okay, so I can write this one. The little number is 3x and let the number 3x and 5x. And if 8 is added, if 8 is added to each number. So, if we add 8 to 3x, what will we get? 3x plus 8. And if I add 8 to 5x, what happened? 5x plus 8. Then, what I am doing? We take 3/5 as 3x and 5x and we add 8 in both cases 3x plus 8 and 5x plus 8, then the ratio becomes 2:3. So ratio become 2:3, that means 3x plus 8 by 5x plus 8 equal to 2/3. This is our required equation. So here I also cross multiply each other. Okay, now I multiply 3x into 3 is 9x plus 3 into plus 8 24, 2 into 5x is 10x and 2 into 8 is 16. Now I take 16 here and 9x on the other side, we get x equal to 8. Here, from this equation solving, I get x equal to 8. So the number are 3x equal to 3 into 8, that is 24, and 5x equal to 5 into 8, that is equal to 5 into 40. So answer is, number is 24 and 40. So this is our last problem of this class. This came at year 2012. What the question said? The monthly pocket money of Ravi and Sanjeev are in ratio 5:7 and their expenditures are in ratio 3:5. If each save rupees 80 every month, find their pocket money. So their ratio of pocket money is 5:7. So I can write their pocket money, let their pocket money is 5x and 7x and they use it, the ratio 3:5. So they have used five y, and each of them save 8 rupees. So their pocket money is 5x. Suppose Ravi pocket money is 5x and he used 3y and he saves 8 rupees. So I can say pocket money minus use of this money equal to save, that is 80. And in case of Sanjeev, it become 7x minus 5y equal to 80. These are our desirable equation. So we have to solve x and y, but not particularly y. We have to just solve x, because x is related to our pocket money. So if we solve this x, we will get our answer. So I now solve the equation. So I solve this in above of the board. If I multiply equation 1 into 5 and into 3 in equation, multiply 3 in equation 2, what will you get? Listen very carefully. 5 into 5, 25x, 3 into 5, minus 15y, equal to 80 into 5, okay. Now here, 7 into 3, this is 21x, 5 into 3, that is 25y, and 80 into 3, so changing the sign, which we cover to get 15y, 15y is cancelled. 25 minus x minus 24x equal to 4x. And 18 to 5 is 400. And 18 to 3, 240. So x equal to 400 minus 240 by 4. Okay. It becomes 160 by 4. That means x equal to 40. Okay. Now these are the values of their pocket money, 5x and 7x. So their pocket money respectively 5 into 40 equal to 200 and 7 into 40 that is 200. This is our answer. So today we have discussed 4 problems. You should practice all 4 problems. So this is enough for today. Keep practicing. Thank you.